it's Fran again in the lab, yada yada, table one. Hey, I picked up this little novelty gizmo at the local shop. It was a must-buy, although it was not cheap, $12. But I was compelled to find out what this was. It's a send-a-sound recordable greeting card. And the instructions show something that I thought was kind of creative. I haven't opened it up yet, but I assume that it's based on the same chips that my little digital sound recorder cartridges that I make are based on, these all chip on board tiny little, you know, chips that will record 10 seconds or more of digital audio. And they've got the A to D, D to A converters in them. They've got a little amplifier, and basically all you need is just a microphone, a switch, and a speaker and a battery to make them work. And they're kind of ubiquitous in those audio greeting cards. But this one is a little different because this has the option to record your own message and then send it and someone else can play it back. From the instructions, it shows that there's a creative way of doing this using sort of pop-up book technology. And then after you record your message, you put that flap down and tape it down with a special seal that they include so that the next time someone opens it up, it turns on the playback switch. I wanted to try this out, and then I wanted to tear it open. Not a tear down, but a tear open. First tear open. So yeah, let's take a look at it. All right, so here we go. Send a sound. Looks like a cassette, but it's not. It's actually just like a cardboard folder thing. Breaking the seal. Can't take it back now. Well, I mean, I could, but... All right. Tape. It's sort of a foldable origami, like, yeah, it's like a pop-up book kind of thing. You got that outer flap. Oh my god, that's cool. You got like the inner cassette thing. That is really cool. And there's obviously the paper flap that's gonna operate the playback part. Yeah, there's actual circuit board in there. It's not like just one little chip on board. There's quite a lot going on in there. So I've got some support, and also this says that it's a two-minute message, which is a lot longer, because my little chip cartridges, they're only like 10 seconds at the highest sample quality, and I've stretched them to like 20 seconds with some pretty serious diminishment in fidelity, so this obviously has a lot more memory than that. 2 minutes, let's check out the fidelity. I'm going to make a short message. Hey, it's Fran making a message on the recordable greeting card just to test the fidelity. Let's hear what that sounds like. Then we close it up. And the next time someone opens it.
Hey, it's Fran making a message on the recordable greeting card just to test the fidelity. Let's hear what that sounds like.
That's not terribly good, but all right. Well, it's got a basic idea how this works. So, well, let's take a look. I want to open this up and see exactly what they had to put in this to get all of this functionality. I'm going to try to open this in a way that I don't destroy the car, because I do want to put it back together. I could probably just separate it together. It looks like it's hot glued. Yep, hot's not. So it's been hot glued together. So see if I can separate this without totally destroying it. Oh, that's really, ooh. Yep. That's a good blob of glue in there. All right, that is some super, super duper hot glue. Huh, ew, yeah, it's really sticky. I guess this is like super hot glue. It's got extra adhesive in it. They didn't want that coming apart. Ah, all right. Here we go. Take a look inside here. All right. Yeah, you can see they got. Looks like they got some foam around a button there. They got the microphone there. The speaker back there. All right. So I'm just gonna continue to take this apart. Yeah. They really glue that together. All right. Whew. So this is all like glued on the inside. Did they ever intend for this to be seen, or is this like made from like a different kind of product? Because they actually went and printed all this and glued it in. Thing here about cassettes. Cassettes are manufactured in something the strictest quality control. Yeah. So. Yeah, they went all out with all this printing just to glue it on the inside. It's pretty interesting. All right, so there we are. There's the guts of it. Yeah, well, it's coming apart a little bit there. One of the batteries is kind of trying to get away. There you go, get in there. Okay. So there's the contact switch, so that when you open and close, that this is exactly the same way that they do it in greeting cards, where they have the flap that just basically acts as an insulator. The contact is always closed unless you close the flap and push that paper in between the contacts, and then it shuts it off.
Hey, it's Fran. Making a message.
There you go.
On the recordable greeting card, just to test the fidelity.
Got a little surface mount chip here. I don't know if I can zoom in close enough for that. It's a Boya Micro. Has anyone ever heard of Boya Micro chip? It's decoded 2018. I would think all the D to A to A to D conversion be done on the chip that's on board. Boya Micro. And it's got the typical little dynamic speaker. Well, this is a 16 ohm. It's kind of unusual. I got a lot of these little dynamic speakers, but the ones I got for my Sputnik project are all 8 ohm. 16 ohms, 25 milliwatts, and there's the little switch mounted on a piece of foam. So I was thinking, you know, $12 is an awful lot to spend on a greeting card, but they actually packed a lot into this. It does have 3 lithium batteries, so it's running on a higher voltage. It's got the separate audio amp chip, I guess, so it's a little bit louder. It's got a larger dynamic speaker than your average greeting card, and it does come with the microphone in it and everything, so. Yeah, I guess, you know, $12, you are buying a lot of hardware. I think if I were to cobble something like this together from, you know, I know that my own chips I got, these little 10-second chips were not really cheap. I think buying like a dozen at a time, these things were still like $5 or so. They weren't like nickel cheap. And then, you know, but for 2-minute recording, plus the, you know, more powerful amplifier built and everything, and plus the bigger speaker and the microphone and everything. If you went out and bought all this on eBay, you'd probably hit $12 easy. Well, I thought this was kind of interesting. I'm going to put this back together, though. So. Tape. All right. Good as new. All right. So let me record a new greeting for this and I'm gonna pause and play it back.
All right, that's it for this one. I'm Fran. Thanks for watching, and thanks too to all my patrons over there on Patreon who make all these videos possible. Thank you. If you like my videos, if you like what I do, if you want to be a part of Team Fran Lab, it's easy to do. You just follow the link in the description. Become a patron. Even just $1 a month. Get you all kinds of exclusives. I do extra videos every week, exclusive little junk, blog posts, yada yada. Little perks that you get just by, being a supporter of Fran Lab. Anyway, that's it. I'm Fran. I'll see you back in the lab real soon. Bye!
Close it up, and the next time someone opens it,
okay.
Oh, you fucker.